Welcome back to Commodity Champions, and joining us now is NITI Aayog member and the architect of the coming agri policy, Ramesh Chand. Dr. Chand, hi, thank you so much for joining us. Well, there's a lot of meetings that have been happening in Delhi and reports being submitted on the agriculture growth and increasing farmer income. What is the maths now on how much growth, until how long, and in what department is needed to ensure the desired results?
Actually, immediately after our Prime Minister gave a call for doubling farmer income, we analyzed this situation in all its dimensions and look at possibility, prospects, and how we can do it. So we looked at not only production, not only price, we also looked at other possibilities of reducing the number of people who are dependent on farming. So taking all these factors into consideration, we found that if we are to double income by year 2022, then we require growth rate in the base level of farmer income of 10.4% every year. But many people, they confuse it with growth rate in production. So when we are saying that that to double farmer income by year 2022, we require annual growth rate of 10.4%, that doesn't mean that physical production has to grow by this amount. According to our roadmap, according to our framework, in order to achieve 10.4% annual growth in farmer income, what we require is that that physical production of agriculture should be growing something like, say, 5% or so. And if we look at experience of last 2 years after this announcement of this goal for doubling farmer income, so last year growth rate in production was about 6.1%. This year we are expecting 3% growth. So whatever contribution of production is required, I find that we are on track. Then the second source we looked at was diversification. Third source we looked at was scope of irrigation expansion in contributing to doubling farmer income, increase in crop intensity, and things like this. But price, since you raised this issue of price also, prices also have very important role to raise income of the farmer. And in our model, we just thought that the role of prices will be something like 1/5, that 20% of the increase in income of the farmer will happen through better terms of trade for agriculture, better price realization. And that is what will be achieved to a large extent through implementation of two budget proposals on agriculture prices.
Well, you know, just taking a leaf out of what you said, Dr. Chand, of course, prices are of most important because we are looking at strong growth production in last couple of years, but a higher MSP, and as you said, there is going to be a higher spend on infrastructure, irrigation, crop intensity. So what is the final spend that we are looking at from the government? And the other part really is that what is the impact on inflation that could be expected from this?
You see, again, spend is on several things. One is spend on infrastructure, including irrigation. So you might have heard that this Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, which has 4 or 5 components, so that is happening in a result-oriented way. There are several aspects of it. That in the past, we have been making investment in irrigation, but area under public irrigation scheme was not expanding to that extent. So now new design has been prepared. We are developing command area. We are looking at possibility of reducing gap between irrigation potential created and irrigation potential utilized. So that is one aspect of government allocation, government expenditure. Now coming to this prices, that how much impact this implementation of budget announcement on MSP will have on inflation. Manisha, it will depend upon implementation of market reforms. I feel this is best opportunity for the center to provide incentive to the states that, okay, center is willing to support you in terms of higher MSP, in terms of implementation of MSP, but you should go for implementation of market reform. Once the state do it, then you just find that the large price spread between producer and end user or producer and consumer which we have, there is a considerable scope to reduce that price spread between farmer and plate. So I feel that this implementation of these budgetary proposal, it will not be entirely transmitted to wholesale or retail level if we are implementing market reform in agriculture. So our take is that these two things should happen simultaneously. That okay, center is supporting in terms of MSP, but state should also agree to implement model APLM Act and undertake necessary reform in agriculture sector.
That point is well taken, Dr. Chand, but give us a bit of an insight. I mean, as you said, there are concerns between the center and the state as well on what their agenda is, but there has been a lot of talks between center and state governments. Where do they stand as of now? What is the agri policy that you seem forming up? And what is the sense on implementation? When do we see that?
You see, the meeting which we had, we just discussed the proposal of Ministry of Agriculture with the states. So Ministry of Agriculture, they came with three proposals, which were broadly that one possibility is that states go for physical procurement. The way they have been going under a scheme which already exists, which is price support scheme, PSS. So under that scheme, already states are procuring some pulses, some oil seeds, and the loss incurred in this process up to some capping is borne by the central government. So one scheme which was proposed by Ministry of Agriculture was market assurance scheme, which is almost same as the existing price support scheme. Then the second was that rather than going for physical procurement, because if you go for physical procurement, storage, disposal, then roughly the cost comes to 15% of MSP. Then there is a second option which already has been tried by state of Madhya Pradesh, that you do not physically enter into market, you don't enter into procurement mechanism, but you just pay the difference in price announced by government, MSP, and the price realized by the price actually received by the farmer, which is called deficiency price payment. This is the second major, I will say, payout. So these are the two main kind of proposal which were made and discussed that day. Now you see, up to an extent, it's okay that center bears 100% of the burden. But if you want to expand it, say, beyond some level, then it is that state should also share some of it. And the second aspect of it is that you know that price of a commodity can be lower than MSP for two reasons. One is that market is not offering remunerative price to a farmer. The second situation could be that quality of produce is such that its price is lower, not because market is not offering him that price, but because that inherent quality of produce is like that. So we have to take care of that thing also, that we need to pay price difference to the farmer up to this inability of market to pay him remunerative prices. So we discussed all those things and looked at nuances and different aspects of it. And Ministry of Agriculture also proposed another idea, which is not yet very much crystallized. The idea was to explore that is it possible to involve private sector in procurement of commodities whenever the market price falls below MSP, and you pay some commission to the private sector or you give some incentive to the private sector for export or allowing them to be kept, say, outside Essential Commodity Act or something like that. But not much clarity on that particular proposal of involvement of private sector. But these were the three proposals which were suggested by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare and which were discussed with the states. I would only like to share one point with you that states did not show preference for single scheme. They showed, some states showed scheme for one scheme, other states showed preference for second scheme, some states showed preference for both, that we want one and two, we want two and three, we want one and three. So there were all kind of opinion from state side. And obviously, it depends upon so many factors, situation of the state, how efficient are their own procurement agency, whether they would like to go for A, B, or C. So this was the kind of preference which was expressed by states.
All right. So while we are still waiting for consensus building up on what scheme really should be put out, Dr. Chand, is there another meeting slated anytime soon for that? What is NITI Aayog now doing? Are you writing more papers? Are you taking more feedback? What is the procedure being followed right now?
From NITI Aayog side, we have looked at its all dimensions. We have looked at different possibility, different combinations, that if we pay 15% price deficiency, 20% price deficiency, 25% price deficiency, and we make different combination, 100% wise center, some sharing like that. So that complete report from our side a few days back we submitted to the Prime Minister office. I think they are now in the process of discussing with the concerned ministry, and I think that that they will soon come out with the final position on that.
So, Dr. Chand, before we let you go, one very crucial question, and this is on what now happens. As you said, PMO is now talking to various ministries. So how soon do we see a final clarity, a rule, a reform coming on this? And when do you see a final implementation?
I can't precisely tell you, but the kind of priority which is given to this thing is that though budget says that we will do it from next Kharif season, but the intention of this government which is told to us is that they want to unfold it before the Rabi season itself, that they want to see it, that it get implemented even in Rabi season. So taking clue from there, I think it should happen very soon, maybe 2-3 weeks, but it should happen very soon.
All right. We will watch out for that timeline then, Dr. Chand. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, that's an important information really coming in from NITI Aayog, that it could be 2-3 weeks that we see a final rule regulation reform come in sense of agriculture, doubling the farmers' income, and that it could happen in the month of April itself. So that is a timeline to watch out for in sense of that strategy. But with that, we're completely out of time on this edition of Commodity Champions. Thank you so much for watching.